broken. So when you read further, he said, behold, the days come, said the Lord, when I will make a new. Who is having something new on today? God bless you. Something new. God bless you. Something new. God bless. Something new. Whenever you buy something new from the shop, you have intention of wearing it on Sunday morning. It seems as if Saturday night doesn't go away. If Saturday night is expanded, 1 minute look like 1 hour. You will be thinking, lying down in the bed, thinking about that clothes in the wardrobe, how you're going to iron it, how. My wife is an example of that. Amen. Amen. Saturday, you bring. Can you please iron this for me? Iron it carefully. I just bought it. I say, yes, madam. Why? Anything new has something sensational in it. You cherish it. You love it. Amen. But hope. Let me continue. So, God said, because of what he did, I'm going to make a new covenant. Those covenants he did with them, he wrote everything down on the stones, on tablets. The people say, no. Father God, we will do it, we promise you. But new covenant in verse 9, he said, not according to the covenant that I made with their forefathers in the day when I took them out of the hand of Egypt. Because they continued not in my covenant, I regarded them not. So if you are here, you don't regard God's covenant, God will regard you not. Did I write the Bible? Yeah. Is it in your Bible? Yeah. You can take that page off, I don't care. But what is written is success. So God said, because those people did not regard his covenant, he regarded them not. Now, in our dispensation, in our generation, he said, I'm going to do what? A new. Say new.
New.
New. And this new covenant, look at verse 10, what does he say? Verse 10 says, for this is a covenant that I shall make with the house of Israel after those days, said the Lord. I will put my laws in their hearts. I will put my laws in their hearts. I will put my laws in their hearts. That's why I said, never let what anybody think about you change you. Never let what somebody talk about you change you. Why? Because God will put it in your
mind.
Not my mind, your
mind.
Your own big head. So when that day comes, you stand before the Father, you are going to judge for yourself, not me. And the next one is he put it in their
hands.
Should I continue?
Yes.
Good. And he said, hey, there was somebody for. I will write them in their hearts, and I will be their. Let me take a step back. Very close now. I repeat verse 10. This is the covenant that I will make in the house of Israel those days, comma. Those who were here in the revival Friday, God did something here. We broke the word of God into smaller pieces. And we knew that those commas, full stops, semicolons, apostrophes, question mark, they are like a cement within blocks. When you walk on the street, you see houses built, you see one stone upon each other, there's something right in between, they are cement. With that cement, what will happen to the building? It will fall off. Let's go back to 10. I didn't want to go down to that area, but I want you to understand something here. I repeat, for this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, comma. Anytime you read a sentence, there's a comma, it means, hold on, relax. After those days, which days are that? They begin to think about which days were that. They were those days when they brought them out of the land of Egypt. Those days that they were on the desert. So you know that day, right? Then he continued. He said, say the Lord, semicolon. Whenever you see semicolon, it's a long pause. Who is saying this? The Lord is saying this. Anytime you hear God speak, what do you do? You listen what?
I like the word.
You listen what?
Attentively.
Good. I'm going back to the sentence. He said, say yes the Lord, semicolon. So you draw your chair, open your ears, and listen to what the Lord is going to say. But I read like that today. What you say one thing here, they get out there. I continue. He said, number one, I will put laws in their mind, comma. That means God is going to put it in my mind. But what is already in your mind? Paul said, be therefore transformed by the renewal of your mind. So if you don't change your mind, God's laws, his covenant laws, will not fit your mind. Do you understand this one? Should I continue?
Yes.
Good. There's a comma there. And again, he said, and write them in their hearts. Double point is colon. Double full stop. Hold on. Wow. You take a deep breath. You say, God has written something on my mind. It didn't end there. He made a comma and now on my heart. That means that is very, very important. And what has he written on my heart and my mind? His laws. Mind you, anytime God speaks, it becomes a law. Anytime God speaks, it becomes a law, whether you like it or not. John chapter 1, verse 1, the Bible says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. So the moment God writes his own word in your mind and heart, God is where in your mind and your heart. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I told you, I always teach, but I'm driving a bit away from it. No problem, we come back to the same route. So people are what, this new covenant is not just a mere covenant, but it's a covenant whereby God himself is on your heart and in your mind. So if you are in love, those of the adult one, excuse me, if you have never fallen in love before, this is not for you. If you are in love before, the person is always on your mind. When you are even embarrassed, you will sing it about the new love you have found. Even at your job place, your boss will say, put a sticker here. But because the person is your mind, you put a sticker there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Is God like that today in your life? The person that you love so much that even when they kick you from your job, you don't care. He's on your mind, right? But is God there in your mind? We're talking about a new covenant. Should I continue?
Yes.
Good one. So he said, under the new covenant, God promises to live in their hearts and provide the grace and the power which is necessary to keep the commandments. Some people think that covenant of grace, we are free from the law. That's what some people think. That we are not under the law, we are under the grace. Well done, well said. But the grace is there to give you the power to override the law. Let me say amen.
Amen.
For God has already put his laws in your heart. Amen. And I told you that the word of the Lord is his laws, his words are his laws. So if Satan, by peradventure, whisper into my ears and say, you are going to die, I tell you, Satan, you know, you lie. Why? Because God has written in my heart that I shall not die, I shall live to proclaim the goodness of the Lord. Hallelujah. Peradventure, I am sick. I didn't tell that I am sick. They saw how I was doing, they told me I was sick. They rushed me to the hospital. The doctors mistakenly take up their operation knife and cut me open. The doctor will read and say, hey, the transgressions of me was upon him. The peace of my assessment was upon him. By his stripes I am healed. The doctor will just close my body and say, my friend, go home. Why? He has seen the word of God in me. Hallelujah. What has God written on your heart? What has God written on your heart? As I just said it, he said, he was wounded for my transgressions. The chastisement of my peace, the peace in the home, the peace in the marriage was upon him. By his stripes, I am healed. So doctor, my friend, sew me up and let me go home. Because that's what you have read in me. That is the covenant I'm talking about. God has written his laws on your heart. Amen.
Amen.
Most of the times you pray and we don't see the results coming. Do you know why? We are forgetting that the covenantal laws are on our hearts. And anytime you pray to God, you take God by his word, he acts upon it. For the Bible says in Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 12, that I watch over my word to perform it. Is that in your Bible? I watch over my word to perform it. And when God watches over you, what does he see? Problems, working problems, documental problems, marital problems, boyfriend problems, girlfriend problems. Where is the covenantal laws? He said, I walk over my word to what? To perform it. But when God watches over you, he doesn't see his word. So he has nothing to perform. So you pray from night to night. Nothing happens. Because when he comes, he's coming to see his word and perform it. Where is it? Clap for God. For the new covenant, he said, I'm going to write my laws on their, talk to me, on their
mind.
And their
hearts.
So when you are sick, what quotation do you quote? Say, so God, remember your covenant you made with me, oh? Huh? You said, healing is the food of your children, but now I'm sick. Your covenant law says, you have written on my heart, that by your stripes I am healed. Lord, I leave it over to you, period. Close your eyes and sleep. You are already healed because of the covenantal laws he has written in your heart. But come 3 hours here and come and say, close your Bible and say something from the Bible, quotation. All of them will say, Jesus wept. Jesus wept. Don't tell it, Jesus wept. That's all. No adult Christian has enough of God's words in his heart. And that's a shame. Those are your covenantal secrets. Now, what covenant do you have? What covenant do you have? You might think that you are human, so it's impossible for you to keep the covenant. God is not only a covenant establishing God, as I said earlier, but it's a covenant enabling God. Amen. He enables you to keep it. That's why he became a man, so that you can become like him. He didn't say amen. God became a man, so that you can become like him. When he says came on earth, how many legs did he have? How many heads did he have?
One.
Was he conceived like you were conceived?
Yeah.
Was he born after 9 months?
Yeah.
Did he walk like you walk?
Yeah.
Did he eat like you eat? Was he says a man? Yes. He was in fact 100% a man. It was hard for you to believe he was a God. He was 100% a God. It's hard for you to believe he was a man. That's what Jesus was. Amen.
Amen.
So the Son of God became the Son of Man, so the sons of men will become the sons of God. Jesus on earth was 100% a man and 100% God. He was so God that it was difficult for you to believe he was a man, and he was so much a man that it was difficult for you to believe he was a God. He was born of a woman, yet begotten of the Father. He was Mary's baby and Mary's God at the same time. Amen. But I feel like I'm preaching. He was enough a man to feel sorry for me, but he was enough God to come and save me. He was enough a man to feel sorry for the multitude, but as a God, he fed them with 5 loaves and 2 fishes. He was a man to fall asleep on the boat, but he was a God to wake up and say, hey, peace, be still. Hallelujah. As a man, he died, and as a God, he resurrected. Amen. As a man, he bled and died, but as a God, 3 days later, he resurrected. Jesus was a man like you and I. He saw the covenant that God had with you. So he laid all his glory out there in the heavens and came down on earth and bled for Adam's race. That is his blood. That seals the new covenant. So Satan knows this. He knows it. Satan knows it. He was there from the very beginning. He was there with God. He knows it. So he knew that if this man goes to the earth and die, and share his blood for them, he's going to seal the new covenant with their blood. Hallelujah. I feel like I preach here. Please, God, can I preach like I feel? All right. So when he says came on the cross, when he said it is finished, he didn't say I am finished. He said it is finished. What was finished? The covenant is finished. He has already seen with his blood. And that's the blood we have here today. Don't see these things you see here as things you buy from Aldi. No. Have a supernatural sight. See beyond what people see. Anytime you see beyond what people see, you become very exceptional. Me, I see things differently. I don't see the things we see. When you come and the chairs are empty, I begin to laugh. The Holy Spirit, you are going to surprise me. That's why the chairs are empty. By the time you realize the chair is full, it's a surprise. Amen. What is your covenant? Are you part of the old covenant, or you are part of the new covenant? The covenant that God himself came down as a man. Maybe you didn't understand what I said earlier. I said he was 100% a man. It was hard for you to believe he was a man. He was 100% a God. It was hard for you to believe he was God. That's why when the storms was lighting like that, he was sleeping and snoring. He was snoring. But as a God, he woke up and said, hey, peace, be still. Jesus was a man. He was a God. He sealed the new covenant with his precious blood. If you have 3 children or 2, and one has to be operated, and the knee or something inside the child is not functioning, and one of them has to be sacrificed to save the life of the other, what will you do? What will you do, sister? Mama Branca, how many kids do you have? How many? Four. By God's grace, I'm getting my sixth one. Amen. And all the six, yeah, I'm going to tell you, I'm going to fulfill your covenant. Yeah, you can have, I'm blessed. And God will always provide a means for me to take care of them. Oh, yes.
Amen.
Yes, he will provide a way. Whether he liked it or not, because I didn't tell him to write, fulfill the earth and submit. I didn't tell him to write. He wrote it. Amen. And as long as I'm part of, clap for me. Amen. And none of these six will I even want to lose. No. Don't want to lose any one of them. So when the doctors mistakenly say something, one have to operate and take the same, my friend. Go back to your books. Go and read. I cannot take kidney from my son and give to this son. What is wrong with you? Go back to your books. God didn't say that. Amen. I don't want to lose any one of them. But God, he had only how many? One. In the beginning, I said, whenever God speaks, it becomes a law. He said in Genesis 8 that as long as the heaven remains, seed time and harvest time will never cease. God, in the time he made the law, he respected it. So when he wanted to let people grow from that earth, he had one seed, who was Jesus. He planted them on earth, he watered it, and Jesus began to grow. Now, how many have Jesus born now? How many are we? Millions. Millions all over the world because of just one seed. One seed. Clap for this God. What am I trying to say? Whenever God's peace becomes a law, that law, he said he has written it on your heart. Brother, on your heart. Sister, on your heart. It's a hard time you take God by his covenant and say, God, you have a covenant with me, so Father, arise and come to my aid.